Hello everyone, I am Zukic and this is my first tutorial video. Apparently, you guys have asked quite a few times for me to make one. Although, I'm not even sure why, because I see myself as the last person you want to learn from, as I've never been to an art school. So, I don't know if it's a good idea to learn from someone who doesn't have a degree in art, but a coloring tutorial from me was the most requested thing in the comment section. So, there you have it. Don't regret it though, you asked for this, kinda. Anyway, I'll try my best to make this video useful for you guys. Before we begin, I'm sorry that my version of site is not in English, but I remember in the comment section you said that it's okay as long as I translate everything, plus all the buttons and brushes and all are all in the same place anyway. Also, I'm sorry that my voice sounds a bit off. I've got a cold, my throat is a bit sore, and I'm having a hard time breathing through my nose, so that explains everything. I've got this line art you've been watching me draw for the whole time I was rambling like a crazy person. It's a gift from Max Mofo for his birthday, and I decided to make something, as you can see. So here we go, a step-by-step tutorial on how to ruin your life. I mean, on how to color, which is the same thing, pretty much. Anyway, just give me a second to finish this line art. Named Jeff. Alright, so the first thing I do is create another layer below the one with my line art and fill it in with a neutral color that won't hurt your eyes, like gray for example. Of course, you could pick any color you like or even just leave it white, but I personally find it really inconvenient because it distracts me from the colors I will be using. I then use a bucket tool to fill in the background. The next thing I do is use the magic wand tool and select brush to select the space I'm going to fill for the basic colors. When everything is selected, I create a few different layers below my line art, and each of them has its own purpose. The first one is for hair, the second one is for skin, etc. To me, it's important to have everything separated as it makes the shading process easier because everything has its own place. So when it's all done, we're ready to shade. Let's start with his hair. I create a new layer above the layer with the hair, and I tick the box over here that, if I remember correctly, says clipping group in the English version of Sai. It allows you to draw on the particular layer without crossing the lines of it and without touching any other layer. After it's done, I pick a random color for the first layer of shading, the basic shade. I usually go for dark red. Afterwards, I create the second layer for shading and I make that one a little bit darker than the first one. Finally, the third layer, I just pick a random color once again, but this time it's gonna vary from the dark red I've chosen before. It can be blue, green, purple, anything you want. Adding these sort of colors gives the drawing a little bit of volume. So when all the three layers are sorted, I go to filter and play with the hue saturation for each layer. I compare every color and keep changing it until I'm happy with the result. I mainly use the ink brush for the shades. It doesn't have any specific options, you can see the settings right here. No blending colors, no textures, no nothing. But what I do use is the blur tool for the soft effect and an eraser with 45% opacity to make the shades kind of fade. I also often create a fourth layer and use the airbrush tool to make shades and gradients, which also gives the drawing a little bit more detail. The same rules apply to the rest of the layers, like skin, clothing, etc. When it's done, I make sure that everything matches by playing with hue saturation for a bit more. When I'm okay with the way things are, I combine the layers with my basic color and shading. So I now have three layers, skin, hair and clothing, all shaded. Then comes my favorite part, the coloring of the line art. I don't like to leave the lines all black, I prefer to make it match the other colors. Again, I created another layer above my layer node and tick the box that says clipping group. I use the color picker tool to copy the colors and make them a little bit darker, and just start coloring my layer node. After it's all done, I combine all the layers together and add some light shades to give the drawing a little bit more volume. So when that is dealt with, all we need to do is add some glare on the hair and the eyes. Afterwards, I of course go to Photoshop to create the outline and use the button Make Pretty. For the outline, I select my layer, click on the blending options and choose the option that says Stroke. Then I pick any color, in my case it's white. Hope nobody gets triggered by this. And finally, it's time for the Make Pretty button. I go to the image, adjustments, curves and just play with the colors until I feel like it's decent enough. And we're done! I know this is not my best work by far. Being sick while drawing and making a video was not the brightest idea of mine. But I still hope that you guys find it at least a little bit useful. If you have any other questions or suggestions, just leave them in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to give it a like and subscribe if you're new. Also, in case you really like what I'm doing and want to support me, I have a Ko-fi account and a Redbubble store. So check these out if you're interested. As usual, on my Twitter and Instagram @imzukic. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day!